Hi, my name is Jonas from Danier Accounting, and in this video here I just want to briefly describe the different company structures that you can choose from when you're starting a company. So the first thing that you need to decide is whether or not you want to have a liability your own, or if you want to isolate this liability inside a company structure. So the first type of company, which is the company where you are liable yourself, is a sole proprietorship. In Danish we call it enkeltmandsfirma. You might have heard it if you're already researching. And the other type is the limited liability companies, where we have two that is the most common, but there is a multitude of other company structures as well. But in this video I'm just going to describe the most common ones. So let me illustrate here on the whiteboard. So the first thing we have is the sole proprietorship. Yeah, I think you can see what that is, and I can illustrate that with a man here or a woman. And these two individuals here, if they decide to establish a sole proprietorship, then they basically are liable for everything that company does, meaning that if they have a credit in the bank, if they owe money to suppliers, or if they fail to deliver something and end up in a lawsuit, then they are liable themselves with all the private assets. It could be that they have an apartment or they have a house. Well, if they should end up losing a lawsuit, or if they should go bankrupt, then they will need to sell their private assets to pay for these obligations that the company has. So for some people that's not a very good idea. For other people it is. It all depends on your situation. There are a few benefits with the structure as well. It's very easy to start, it's very cheap to start, and if you expect to have a deficit in the beginning, you might also be able to offset this deficit in other incomes. Maybe you have a job or something. Well, in that case, a deficit in a sole proprietorship can actually help you tax-wise. Other people prefer to isolate the liability in a company structure. So I will try and illustrate that here with a small house. And the company structures that we see the most are the ones called an APS. And we also have one called an IVS. They're both limited liability companies, and what makes them different from each other is the capital requirement when you establish the company. The APS is the old limited liability company that everybody knows, so there is also some kind of goodwill related to having an APS in Denmark. You need to have 50,000 Danish kroner. This is the initial capital requirement to establish the APS. An IVS is a newer form of limited liability company. I would say that in reality it's not a big difference if we speak about the goodwill versus the IVS. I mean, it is a new company structure, but very seldomly you will hear anybody comment on it. An IVS is meant for people that is entrepreneurs. If you translate it directly, it will be a limited liability company for an entrepreneur. That's kind of the name. And the idea with that is that you can actually establish this company if you have anywhere between 1 kroner to 49,999 kroner. So naturally, for a person that don't want to have the personal liability but wants a limited liability, but doesn't have 50,000 kroner in the bank, let's say you just start your first business, well, then this is a really good option because you can get this IVS by only having 1 Danish kroner in equity. The only other thing that differs these two is that the IVS, there is a requirement to save up 25% of the revenue every year, and you need to do that for as long as it takes for you to have 50,000 Danish kroner in equity. The same second you have 50,000 Danish kroner in equity, then you are allowed to pay out a dividend to yourself. You're also allowed, if you want, to change the IVS to an APS instead, if you would prefer that. So this here was just in general what I wanted to say about the company structures. We also wrote more about it in our blogs, and you're also able to listen to the podcast if you prefer that. If you have any questions, feel free to send me an email on jonas@danieraccounting.com. You can also call me if that's more convenient, and my phone number is +45, that's the Danish country code, and my phone number is 2627 77 77. If you're already in the process and you're more interested in getting a quote, then on every subpage here on the website you will find a link to get a quote, and here you will get a price, for instance, for establishing one of these company structures. So that's everything I wanted to say. Thank you for your time, and we hope to hear from you soon.